Hey, this is Eric from Cafe Watercolor, and welcome to another quickie painting video. Today we're gonna take a look at this painting I did last year of Hong Kong International Airport. So this photo is taken by my friend Ashley. I think she was there in the business trip. She took this photo, you know, it's just kind of like a snapshot she wanna upload on social media, kind of telling people that, you know, she's there on a trip and things like that. But I saw something special in this photo, so I asked her if I can paint it, and she said, sure, that would be wonderful. Pretty sure she didn't really think much of the photo aside from just telling people she's there. But I think there's a lot of potential in this photo, so that's why I decided to paint it. I did change quite a bit of the composition though. The plane on the right isn't really that big in her photo. I actually make it part of the almost like a foreground element. I decided to cut it off so it feels like the plane is a lot bigger than it seems. So just seeing it's a little bit more of an interesting composition that I plan to do. So instead of painting a painting of an airplane, I want to focus more on just the overall, how big the airport is, how big the airplane runway is, the terminal and things like that. And there's working people and there's trucks and there's also another airplane about to take off and things like that. I think those are the story that I'm trying to tell. And although I painted an airplane before, the composition is quite different from this one. The last painting that I did, which I quite like it myself, the main character is definitely the airplane. While this one, I feel like I'm more trying to convey the whole, the area as a whole, instead of this individual airplane. So I hope this is an interesting painting, and I hope you like this painting. So the drawing for this type of painting is very, very important. If you got vehicles, you got hard surface things, and when you are drawing something like this, things get pretty technical. I need to get the perspective accurate and things like that. Although I didn't use ruler and things like that, I still try to be as accurate as possible without being too stiff. That's why I don't use a ruler or anything. But again, it's still very, very important that I know what I am looking at. I know what I'm drawing. How is the perspective and how is the form? Where is it in the eye level? So starting with the first wash, this is an overcast rainy day, so I don't want to put too much on the sky. So the sky is pretty much just sort of a gray color, and as it enters the horizon, I try to leave out some highlight for the airplane and starting to get a little bit darker. And as you can see, although it is fast forward, I'm trying to be as clean as possible. Even though I'm trying to paint into some of the shadow area, but that doesn't mean I start to worry too much about those. The most important thing for the first wash, especially for something that's this big in scale, the cleanness is very, very important. If you end up with a messy first wash, you are setting yourself up for a bad start. So always remember the first wash is just the light and atmosphere. Getting some directional line in, and after it's dry, I re-wet the sky and I do the background mountain, which is essentially just a very soft shape. It is way into the distance and it's just the background, so the purpose it's serving is just something in the background that will convey the depths and the distance and also the scale. I continue to wash down. This is the second wash. I continue the second wash down and start to darken some of the areas, but I still keep everything very, very clean. This is a little bit bigger painting that I did, so I try to plan things a little bit better and I try not to rush things. In here, I am painting the hangers in the background. Again, it's in the background, so I try not to paint too dark. Just a little bit of shape and a little bit of value. and I bring the value of the hanger out into the background airplane. And like I mentioned before, connecting shape and watercolor is very, very important. The more you can connect, the better. And a lot of time when you are able to connect shape, things merge together and you can just separate it with a little bit of highlight or a little bit of dark later. And if you can connect a lot of shapes, the overall atmosphere just feels a lot more cohesive. So I give a little bit of detail and the airplane and the background. The airplane is about to take off, so it's on the runway. So I really want to kind of paint that in. Even though it's still kind of way into the distance, I want to give just enough detail to convey the airplanes there. So now that I'm starting to work on the airplane on the right, we do need to give it quite a bit more definitions and a lot more care because it's a lot closer to us. I'm trying to go as dark as I can in this wash, because I try not to paint too many layers. A lot of layers can result a muddy painting. I got quite a bit of questions before when people asked me how do they avoid mixing muddy colors. And a lot of time I said, before you think about color, look at how many washes you made and look at your washes. A lot of time it's not really the color that's making your painting muddy. It's you're painting so many layers or you are making muddy washes and your wash is not clean. So that's why it happens quite a bit of times. Because if you look at this painting, the color are not necessarily a very nice, saturated, vivid color. A lot of color is just mixing a bunch of different tones of gray. And I can hardly say those colors are very, very clean because my colors are kind of all over the place. But at the end of the day, it still works. And I think that is because that I'm trying my best to keep the wash clean. So even though I'm going very, very dark right now, I am keeping in mind that I need to make the wash clean so I don't go back to the wash that's about to dry. And also I try not to do too many layers if it's not necessary. I try to do the dark reflection right away because I try to sort of merge everything together. I want it to feel together. So before, I will wait for it to dry and then I'll do the reflections and I'll soften the edge. But in this painting, I try my best to do it in one go. It's a little bit challenging because there's a lot of little details that I try to do, but I think it ended up working nicely. And there you see me pre-wetting some of the areas and I dropping some dark paint so it becomes sort of reflections here and there. Reflection is really, really important if you want to convey sort of this wet day. And I feel like watercolor is such a natural medium when it comes to painting a wet reflection like this. It's because you re-wet the surface and you let the pigment drop into the wet puddle and then it just kind of spread out. It just feels so natural and the result is also looking very natural and believable. So here I am starting to work on the vehicles because I want to let the reflection and the airplane to dry before I go back to it. So about the vehicles, I try to keep them simple without giving them a lot of details and stuff. All the details that I'm doing, I like to say they are perceived detail. I leave a little bit of highlight here, I give a little bit of dark shape there, and the result is when you look at it, you feel like there's something details there, but they're just little brushstroke and visual languages. So I'm painting the yellow vest of the ground crew as the wash for the airplane part is dry and the reflections are dry. I need to wait for them to dry before I do that so that all the shapes that I paint will be defined and they're not going to just spread out of control. So you really need to watch the dryness and the wetness of your painting if you want a certain effect. If you want a hard edge, wait till the layer is dry. If you want a soft edge, then do it wet onto wet. Timing is definitely a huge part of watercolor because unlike oil and acrylic, you can just wait them to dry, or even if it's still not dry, you can usually mix a very thick mixture and paint over them. Watercolor doesn't really work like that. You really need to work with your time and the wetness. And a lot of people think that makes it hard to control, but at the same time, I think it's also a very powerful tool if you understand the property of watercolor. So time can be your enemy, but can also be your most powerful tool once you understand how the painting is going to react in a certain time. So I'm painting some reflection in the distance as well. So it's the same thing. I pre-wet the area that I want the reflection and I drop in the paint. And after I drop in the paint, I kind of squeeze the moisture out of my brush. So I got like a 90% dry brush and just kind of disturb, pull some directional line and make the reflection just disturb it a little bit. So it feels like the ground has a little bit of texture. I'm trying to finish those crates. The left side feels a little bit empty, but you can see that the painting is quickly taking form. Now this part gets a little bit tedious. I don't really enjoy this part, painting those crates and all the hardwares and the cart. But they are kind of necessary to have a balanced image because we got a major shape, which is the airplane and a ground crew on the right. We want something on the left to kind of off balance that. Even though most people will focus their attention on the right because of their where the airplane is, we cannot make it so right side heavy. We want something on the left to set things a little bit balanced. While they are not at the same degree of detail and interest, to have a kind of somewhat balanced image is also a good idea in terms of composition. Now that the wash is dry, I am darkening the turbine. Some part I really need to make it darker, and I'm trying to fill in the background a little bit more. The painting is pretty much finished. It's just some finished touches to make things a little bit better. So I'm darkening the reflection as well as the shadow underneath the airplane. And I'm darkening the foreground as well, so it gives a little bit more depth. And you can see I'm turning the paintings around so the water kind of flow in different directions so it doesn't all just gather in the bottom. Now that is dry, I go back and start to just fill in some very dark details, some dark punches, to make things look a little bit more finished. But this is the final stage of final touches that I shouldn't do too much. Just a few essence here and there. Very important to understand that details are not what makes a painting. What makes a painting is the shape design, the overall value, and just the overall composition, the major shapes. If you don't have a good shape going, you don't have a good composition going, and you're doing detail all day long, it's not going to help. I'm trying to give a little bit more middle tones for the airplane, giving just a few more details, darken some of the areas. Saunders paper is very absorbent, so a lot of dark paint will fade into a lighter value. So I tend to go back if I want something to be really, really dark. I need to do a couple more layers and glazing. There's no way around it, unfortunately. doing some of those painted lines in the ground, and we are finished. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, if you like what I do, please like and subscribe and comment. And if you haven't do so, please sign up on my website to get a fast track watercolor PDF guide. Thank you, and I will see you guys again soon.